Good day, viewers. Welcome back to the Preaching Humanist with David Oliverio. That is I. Today, I want to talk about fighting bad beliefs. I'd like to do a three-part series today, fighting these particular bad beliefs and why we should. Number one, I'm going to use a quote from Sam Harris, one of his books back, 15 years ago or so. He said, "Our beliefs define our vision of the world, they dictate our behavior, and they determine our emotional responses to other human beings." Let's talk about that today. How important it is that we have good beliefs that are good for all, right? So let's talk about they define our vision of the world and our worldview first. So based on your beliefs, I'm going to use this as an example. When I used to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as a young preacher many years ago, and those that continue to believe in gods and spirits and angels and so forth, this is what I call my God glasses. This is my belief system. Now, when I have my belief system here, the vision of the world, my worldview is based on my belief system. Now, myself and many others, years ago, I took this off years ago when I realized there's no evidence for a God. My worldview changed, and the way I treated other people and what I thought changed dramatically based on my beliefs. So, by removing these glasses, the God glasses, the supernatural belief glasses, the spiritualist belief glasses, one will experience a clear vision of a word I like to use all the time, reality. I've been accused many times of being obsessed with reality when I talk to people that believe in supernatural beliefs. I am. I like to be known as someone who is obsessed with reality. Taking these glasses off, you face reality. So really it comes right down to two things. Number one, over here you have, which I say is a melting pot of all supernatural religious beliefs and spiritual beliefs into one pot, all based on faith. That's the worldview based on what they believe. Over here you have those of us that have removed these glasses, and we see reality. To me, reality is naturalism, that belief that nature encompasses all that exists and only of natural elements. Number two, our beliefs dictate our behavior. Now, this is what gets pretty dangerous. That's why I call this fighting bad beliefs. Now, beyond Maslow's hierarchy of needs, which I've discussed before, need deprivation causes drive, which results in behavior. Our behaviors change to meet the next need. Very true. Our basic needs, our behavior changes to meet the next need. Beyond that, why do people do what they do? Because of what they believe. Very important to have good beliefs and not bad beliefs. So why do people do what they do? Because of what they believe. Bad beliefs can produce bad behavior. Now, basically, I will give you a little example. When someone holds a worldview of spiritualism or evangelical Christianity, that will cause them to vote a particular way. Voting behavior, very important. And we will break it down the next two episodes. What about violence in the name of particular beliefs? That happens. What about discrimination against others of different beliefs and worldviews? It's all based on belief systems. That's why people do what they do, because of what they believe. So the next couple episodes, I'm going to discuss this. We're going to go into a little more depth on each one of these. So thank you so much for watching the Preaching Humanist, where no God is required for a life of love, joy, peace, fulfillment, meaning and purpose in life, and the good life is guided by reason and motivated by love. Have a wonderful day.